September 13th already, 2021 will come to order. Let's stand, pledge allegiance, and a moment of silence. I pledge allegiance
to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. Okay, we have three people that will be speaking. Two will be on the Upper Room Youth Center, and then the TIF district proposal. We will limit Mr. Oliver, I believe you are on this, the program actually, so you will have 4 minutes. And anybody after that will have 2 minutes, okay, just so you know. And then with the TIF, that'll be a 2 minute thing. That is actually information only tonight. We're gonna amend the agenda and it's actually a board information, so there's not gonna be no action on that. So just so you know, okay. So I need to have the new agenda. Motion to approve the new agenda, just some highlights for the employment, Mrs. Kimberly Weston there, the 4,000 stipend, as you can see that one, we have added actually Mr. Hedley for a long-term substitute position, we can talk about that, Mr. Tyners has been pulled off. We have two down below, Greg Marl and Mary Waymeyer added in here basically at the last moment. Fundraisers, DCMS and Squires part there. The technology server has been pulled for this meeting. And then the other thing is that the TIF discussion will go to a board information only, guys, and won't actually be no action on it tonight. So if I could have a motion to adopt the new agenda.
So moved.
Thank you, Tim.
Second.
Thank you. We have a motion, second. Any discussion? Questions real quick? If not, all say aye.
Aye.
If we're all here, we don't have. All right. Now, approval of minutes. Approval of July 14th exec session. Also the August 9th regular meeting. Need a motion to approve the minutes of the exec and the August 9th regular meeting.
So we approve the executive session minutes from July 14th to the regular meeting from August 9th.
Okay, thank you. Second.
Second.
Okay. We have a motion second. Any additions to the minutes as presented? If none, all in favor say aye.
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 Opposed? Thank you, guys. All right. Now we're coming to the time of our public hearing. We will suspend the regular board meeting to have the public hearing at this time. And so we will go into that public hearing, which is for the Second Amendment lease, so that we can proceed with our project that the Building Lease Corp gave us approval tonight prior to the meeting to move forward with. Okay, for during this public meeting, this will have time for the public to give us input as we go through here. Mr. Otis, is the best way is to take it on through the agenda, and as we have questions at that point in time,
sure,
to do that. So, to our audience, if you have something that you hear and you want to question, Please raise your hand. It'll be the easiest for me to see, and we will recognize you and answer questions. We have a lot of people here on Zoom as well as here that can handle probably about most of the questions. All right. Mr. Otis.
Thank you. So we'll go through the script here that has been prepared for the this three resolutions that you'll be approving tonight. So pursuant to Indiana Code 20-47-3, before a school corporation may enter into a lease with a nonprofit building corporation, the school corporation must conduct a hearing regarding the execution of the proposed lease and whether the rental to be paid to the lessor building corporation under the proposed lease is a fair and reasonable rental for the proposed improvements. So I think now at this point we'll hear from the circle.
That was conducted by the Board of School Trustees of Delphi Community School Corporation with the assistance of Performance Services and Trimco with respect to renovations and improvements to facilities throughout the school corporation, which include roofing, HVAC maintenance, and site improvements at Delphi Community Middle School and Delphi Community High School. An evaluation of the existing facility was then presented, as well as discussion of the details of proposed projects. Following items were found to be needed by Performance Services and Trimco and were given to the Delphi Community School Board. The list, which is not inclusive, but is completion of the middle school and high school roofing that has already been started. We need to finish the east side of the middle school and over the ag wing. All pneumatic controls for the HVAC system in the middle school need to be replaced. The HVAC in the middle school, all the VAV variable air volume boxes in the high school and in the high school agriculture wing, the high school rooftop handler located above the LMC, domestic piping at the high school and the cafeteria locker rooms and pipes that head towards the middle school. Exhaust fans for both middle and high school need replaced. The Delphi Community School Board has found that a need exists for this project and cannot provide the necessary funds to pay the cost of the project.
Thank you. So now we will open this to the public in respect to the lease for the project. Is there anybody that would like to ask a question or say anything about the project at this point? None here. I do not see any on our Zoom video. So, Mr. Otis or Mr. Long,
sure.
Mr. Otis,
sure.
Please continue.
Yep. So, what you have before you is a resolution authorizing the execution of the Second Amendment to the lease. The prior building corporation meeting, just prior to this meeting, they approved their end of this lease agreement. We're asking for the approval of this resolution for this board. Notice of this hearing was published in the Carroll County Comment on August 11th, 2021, in accordance with the notice requirements under Indiana law. You've been provided with the preliminary plans as well for the use of the funds regarding this lease. Mr. Long, do you have anything else to add regarding this?
Nothing on top of that. You covered it perfectly. If there's any questions from the board.
If there's no, let's get a motion. I need a motion to adopt the resolution authorizing execution of the Second Amendment to the lease.
I move that we approve the resolution authorizing execution of Second Amendment to the lease.
Thank you. Need a second?
Second.
All right, we have a motion, a second. Any questions for Eric or Mr. Otis? All right. Hearing none. resolution assigning construction bid, please.
Yes, thank you. This is a very short resolution. I'll read the entire resolution in the record. Whereas the this is the resolution assigning construction bids and contracts. Whereas the Delphi Community School Corporation has received or reasonably expects to receive construction bids or enter into contracts for the renovation of and improvements to facilities throughout the school corporation, including roofing, HVAC, maintenance, and site improvements at Delphi Middle School and Delphi High School. The project now, therefore, be it resolved, the construction bids and contracts relating to this project are hereby assigned to the building corporation once received.
Thank you. We need to have a motion to adopt the resolution assigning construction bids.
I move that we approve Exhibit B, the resolution assigning construction bids and contracts.
Okay, thank you. Second?
Second.
Thank you. All right, any questions on the resolution of assigning construction bids to the building board? If not, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Thank you. And Mr. O, is the resolution to summarize the authorizing the third supplement to the master continuing disclosure undertaking and the assurance of bonds.
Thank you. And again, this is another short resolution, so I will also read this one into the record. Whereas a third supplement to master continuing disclosure undertaking has been presented to the Board of School Trustees of Delphi Community School Corporation in connection with the issuance of the Delphi Community Multi-School Building Corporation ad valorem property tax first mortgage bond series 2021, and whereas the board must approve the form of undertaking and the issuance of the bonds, now therefore be it resolved that the board hereby approves the form of undertaking and hereby authorizes any officers of the board to execute such undertaking. Be it resolved that any officers of the board are hereby authorized and directed to execute any and all documents and certificates required in order to issue and deliver the bonds.
Okay, thank you. Any motion to adopt the resolution authorizing third supplement to master continued disclosure undertaking an insurance of bonds?
Mr. President, I would move that we adopt the C as presented.
Thank you. Motion, a second. Any questions or discussion on that part?
I would point out, Mr. Schwartzkopf, Mr. Long, if you could just comment. This has been, as I understand it, a recent change in the law regarding disclosure. When you have bonds and then take out new bonds, you have an obligation to report that to bondholders. Is that correct?
Right, so as of 2019, that law changed. We've updated both your written policies as it pertains to bond issues as well as your continuing disclosure document. So basically, anytime you go out and do a public bond issue, there's a requirement that you essentially make a promise to would-be investors that you'll do things like provide your annual financial information, your state board of accounts audits, et cetera. And then as Nick was pointing out, going forward, if you ever enter into any kind of a debt-like obligation, the bond will have to be notified of that as well. Now, in this case, by its very nature, we're going to have an offering document for this bond issue, so that'll check the box for the purposes of this bond obligation, and we just continue that going forward. And I believe Baker Tilly assists as the dissemination agent on that front whenever there's information that has to go out to the bond market.
Mr. Long, again, just kind of generally, the idea is that if existing bondholders essentially have the right to know that you're taking out new debt, you still have the ability to pay their debt, correct?
Correct, yes. That's exactly it.
Other questions or comments? If not, all in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Hearing is now closed, and we open our regular board meeting. Thank you guys for that. All right. Reports. Ms. Circle, we're doing things a little different. The board has had the principals for our other leadership has submitted already reports to them. They will not be up podium to help out on some time, but if you, at the end after Mrs. Circle's report, if you have any question on those reports, they are here tonight to answer those questions. Circle?
I am going to have Mr. Schuller do something for me. We have two of our fine seniors, our senior class officers, are here this evening, and I would like for him to introduce both of them.
Yes. I have two of the representatives for this year that will be on the student representatives for the school board. This is Leah Barnard and Sarah Howard. And they are excited to be part of this process, I believe.
Welcome.
Welcome.
Thank you.
Thank you.
We look forward for you guys to be intervening and you know what you guys can bring to us on the inside has been valuable over the years. I know that. And we know you'll do just the same. So.
Two fine young ladies that are going to represent very well. Very proud of their leadership skills. Okay, a couple of items. Gentlemen and audience, first thank you. It's exciting to see a nice audience here with everything that's been going on. Based on the resolution from January of 2021, the local income taxes is approximately $17,000 a month. Mr. Roth asked back in January of 2021 that we take that money and move to the rainy day. Hopefully all of you remember that. I just wanted to let you know that we are going to be transferring money, $69,790.64, to the rainy day fund. We are hoping to transition this to a quarterly event. Build that rainy day back up. Now we are having a public hearing of the budget Monday, September 27th at 6:30, I believe. Or actually, I'm sorry, I apologize, at 6 o'clock p.m. Collective bargaining will begin. Count day is this Friday. We, right now, with our new system of data exchange, we are somewhere between 1,386 and 1,393. So we're little bit down last year at this time. Bus emergency protocol. Luckily with our bus accident that we had, everyone was okay, even the driver who really had kind of a scare running into the back of the bus. But we did discover with our bus protocol that our Sky Alert, which is the system that makes the phone calls out to parents, that they did not have some of the families on that Sky Alert. So we immediately looked at the protocol that was going on. We have upgraded. We have made sure all the buses are in Skyward, which is where Sky Alert pulls from. So now when Mr. Street needs to make a call for bus 8, he should be able to just go to Sky Alert, select bus 8, and it is pulling directly from a nightly pool of Skyward. So as long as we're keeping up to date in Skyward, those lists should be accurate, because that was a situation that should not have happened. I do want to say, though, everyone that was dealing with the bus situation did an exceptional job. We had Pastor Todd Ladd was there immediately helping out, as well as the school nurse, all the local law enforcement. Mr. Strebick was driving a bus and was still trying to manage the situation and did a great job with this, and Rick was there immediately, so excellent job. You will see on the agenda that we have some bus drivers that are also our employees listed. We are running into a situation, and when I say we, it is not just our school corporation. Every school corporation around us is having the same shortage of bus drivers. It is getting to a critical situation, though, where if we have one out with hip replacement or anything, Ross is scrambling. Ross is automatically driving a bus, so due to allergies. So we are going to have to pull our resources and figure out how we can cover bus routes. One of the things that we have is we have needed resources within our building. So, for example, Greg Morrow is on there. As you know, he's an excellent employee. He's one of our salary employees. He works way well above his hours. He's here on Sundays and Saturdays. He is going to be driving, but we really need to start looking at our policies
I actually, if you mentioned that, I live in La Porte, and one of my good friends sent a text to me that was quite critical of, he's having the same issue, his daughter's not, they haven't had a bus driver a couple days, and they've had to arrange things, so it is definitely going on at every school corporation.
One of the things that has come to our attention as the board, I just want to bring to the forefront. On Saturday, we were short buses and bus drivers, well, actually drivers, because at one point, a couple years ago, we did start involving our middle school club sports and transporting them. So on Saturday, what ended up happening is we just did not have enough drivers by the time we had all our varsity sports and our club sports. Mr. Strebeck made it work, but at some point we're probably going to have to revisit how that looks, because it's just one of those things that ended up impacting, starting to impact going forward. This time, is there any questions for the administrators regarding their board reports?
Yes, the only question I have is the one person with a salary employee, and then we want to pay them also as a bus driver. I guess Nick could answer that question on paying. Can we pay a salaried employee in a different position as an hourly employee at the same time?
Depends on how many hours they have that they're working on the salary. We can discuss that.
That's
not an issue. No, you're under the Fair Labor Standards, you're asking a very good question.
Yeah, no, it was a discussion we had. He does work in the morning and is that too. That's why we looked at the AM. Yeah, Ross, you can have a comment.
I spoke with Dr. Hannah at Rossville, and they have, like, I think your maintenance guy retired, and he was driving for them. He has a teacher that he paid. Because they're salaried, he said I can pay $20 an hour in the morning to be on call from 6 to 8. If the teacher drives, they pay them $44 for half a route. And if they drive both routes, they pay them $88 on top of their salary. On their custodians that drive, they clock out and they get $44 or $88, depending on whether they drive both routes or just half. He says they don't have any trouble. I assume he's probably checking up there, but we're going back here.
And we knew this was going to be a question that came up, and we knew we somehow got a creative resource problem. So that's why I mentioned it in the board report. So thank you.
Okay. Any other questions for Mrs. Circle?
I have a question about the ADM. Do we have students that are currently staying at home that won't be counted, or?
We do have some that are homeschooled. It is not anything that's, you know, exorbitant from, you know, past years. Some of the things that have caused a slight drop is I know last year we did have some transfer students from other local school corporations that possibly might have had different types of schedules with COVID, and since now everyone seems to be going back to a normal as can be in COVID existence, some of them have gone back to school districts.
I just wondered, I saw an email today about the legislature discussing the possible count maybe for ADM on homeschool or kids staying home and down with COVID.
Well, that's a good question. It's been a home issue.
I have a question. How's this professional development now? What's going on?
Busy. Very busy. We have so many things that we're trying to fit in. We're kind of trying to schedule and not step over each other. We're scheduled out through September, and I had to grab some days in October that I needed. So it's been working pretty well. I don't know if any of the administrators have comments, because they're at the ground zero.
It's worked well. There's been a lot. There doesn't feel like there's enough time to be quite honest still.
I'd like to follow up on Chris's her question. Are we having virtual? Are we offering virtual this year like last year we did? Kind of what?
I'm sorry, Chris, if that's what you're asking.
routine matters. There's a lot of things in here. You've all had opportunity to look at it. For the sake of time, unless there is a question on one thing in there, we'll get a motion for the whole routine matters. The consent item claims and payroll amount of $1,525,952.59. You've got the financial reports submitted by treasurer, the employment of certified staff, employment of classified staff in there, ECA positions for the 2021 and 2022 school year, the mentor teacher from the last time that we had tabled those two. We approved, I believe, everything else at that time. We have resignations, fundraisers, facility use requests, and field trips. And I believe that is all in the routine matters. Oh, yes. Sorry. There is. On the ECA, under 14, Sherry Connor, it says 646. That's a typo. Should be 645 like the rest of
them. Mr. Schwartz, we have it in my contract, and it says 646.
646. So everybody should be.
Yeah. That's correct. Well, there's 645 and 646.
Oh, the NHS is 646. Mr. Connor, could I ask a quick question from you?
Sure.
They've got the only one is the NHS sponsor, the dollar more.
Yeah.
Is that, I need guidance from you since you're.
Well, I tell you what, we could, someone could ask Nick since he is here, but I can't. But someone might want to ask Nick if we just let it go and then we take care of it. You know, when we do the contract collective bargaining, and I'll make sure Mrs. Connor gives the dollar back.
Oh well, I'm not worried about that.
I just noticed it though,
right,
that for some reason this guy stuck out. I was going through the list, but
yep.
If you go ahead and approve it now, and then when we do the contract, we'll just bring it back down to 6:45, and if Mrs. Connor boxes that off.
She was
Mrs. Circle of Dollar.
Okay, so we will leave it based off the contract that's in place, right? That we at 646, just to be noted that there is a dollar difference. We'll do it that way. So, need a motion for routine matters A through G as presented?
So moved.
Thank you.
Thank you.
All right, we got a motion, a second, discussion. Questions further on there? Okay. If not, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? There he goes. All right. Get to my stuff here, guys. New business. 6A, adopt policy 3220.01, the teacher appreciation grant. This is something we do every year. And Mr. Circle, do you want to fill us in just a little bit on that? I mean, there's no dollar set amount yet,
no.
Right?
No.
So this is just a proven that we take that money and apply it like it's supposed to be done by policy.
Correct. And I did in your board packet, I put our board policy. I did talk to the association during discussions, and they decided they wanted to do four of the same policies last year. So we don't know the dollar amount yet. There is a difference between the highly effective and effective. By state, we have to have it before the board every single year. So it's back before you again.
So there wouldn't be a payout we'll get later on once we know, but there will be a payout to highly effective and effective teachers, a grant, I guess what they call it, whatever that amount will be determined later. So we need to adopt the policy. Motion and a second. Any questions, guys, on it? All right, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Next is to adopt the DCSC staff performance evaluation plan submission for the 21-2022 year. Again, this is for how people are evaluated, a yearly thing, that we're staying with our current thing in place. We get a motion and a second, and then if there's any questions, we'll move that way. Need a motion?
I move to adopt the DCSC staff performance evaluation plan submission for the 2021-2022 staff.
Any second?
Second.
All right, motion second on table. Questions for Mrs. Circle or whoever else may answer.
So the plan isn't the same as last year. Did we get a copy of that at the next meeting?
It should have been in the board packet.
Yes.
Honestly, it's a status quo. This is another state regulation that we have to complete and evaluate the plan and submit it every year. I did talk with discussions in our last meeting that if this is something we want to look at further, we need to start conversations early on the year. We'll have a committee.
Give me a moment, please.
Yes.
Okay. You've left your speaker here.
Yeah.
It's all right. All right. Any other?
It's by the board packet.
Yeah. All. Any other questions or comments, Mr. Smith? Since you got through that.
I'm fine, thank you.
Okay. All right. All in favor, say aye.
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 Opposed? All right, next is termination of the Weir's contract. This is to give authority to Mrs. Circle to break the contract, basically, or notify them that we will no longer be in a contract situation with them. In that contract, which is in your board packet, there is a 60-day. We want to make sure we get ahead of this and allow Mrs. Circle the more than appropriate time as a board to get out of the contract. Need a motion for termination of the Weir's contract.
Mr. President, I move to move forward with the termination of the Weir's contract.
Okay.
Second.
Okay, thank you, guys. Okay, a motion, a second now. Questions, comments?
I think we'll save a lot of money by doing this. This month alone, we gave them $23,815, you know. And our 2021 lease agreement with them was $250,000. I think we did a lot cheaper than $3 million.
My only question and concern is how confident we will be able to hire a mechanic.
Yes,
pretty sure.
You have plenty of time because this. You're not so much terminating it as you're just non-renewing it after the end of this
December
year.
December 31st, yeah. So we have 3 months. But that's why we want to do it now to notify them. And that will be actually a motion next is a policy to is a proposal.
What are the estimated costs for hiring a room?
When we looked at, basically, the employee costs will be probably close to about $120,000.
Salary benefits,
yeah. There will probably be, honestly, Ross, I mean, probably be a few tools up front, diagnostic equipment maybe, $5,000 to $10,000 maybe?
Five.
Okay.
It could be a little bit higher, but he was pretty secure at $5,000.
So, yeah, we'll have $10,000 with it.
It'd be diagnostic equipment, but he doesn't have that much. He doesn't have that.
Is there going to be a vehicle needed for this person?
Correct. I mean, we have one now, but it would be nice to update it when we can. And that's a succession, just like we did with Greg. Just a normal updated vehicle. It's not just to have. He can get by with what we have currently until we approve another purchase.
Are we looking
hours. Before, I think we were spending about $10,000 a year at Weir's for certain things, certain items. And we try to deal as much as we can locally. We always source local furniture.
Other comments? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? The ayes. Next is a permission to post for transportation mechanic. This will be to replace our contract with Weir's, go back to kind of like we were before and have an in-house mechanic to do our work. We need to be able to post this and see all who applicants we will have.
So I move.
All right, questions, comments?
Comment. I highly suggest we get some sort of a barcode or a way to inventory the tools we're purchasing so that we know what is ours in the future. And have good inventory of parts and all the stuff that go along with being in this business here.
It'll be a good thing to do. Service. We are
residential TIF.
The residential TIF has actually got moved down to in your new pack thing here will be moved down to information only for on the board. It'll be the very last one. Because it wasn't an action item, it was more just for update. It's got moved down to information on school board information on under eight. Performance services. We have acquired our funding for once the bond sold, but we have acquired our funding for to move forward with our projects to for under that. Let's get a motion on the floor and then we can have discussion. This will be for a bid of $4,008,153. So I need a motion. Tim, second. All right, we have a motion, a second. Mr. Nipple and I met with Performance Services last week, right, Chris?
Yep.
And we went through their stuff that we need to do, like the piping and air conditioning, all that have HAV stuff, the pneumatics to digitize, like we've been talked about on that. We do have them here, I believe. They're still here. Tony is, and he is, and so if you have any question, you know, that would be a thing to maybe talk with them. They went through, actually there was a couple adjustments we did, just so you know. Before they had a $50,000 customer allowance, which is override in case we wanted to do something. They actually came in their bid actually $50,000 cheaper when they came in versus what they initially sent us. So we just took that and added it to the allowance, customer allowance, which actually pushed it to $100,000 basically. That allows us to, once we get down towards the end of the project, if there's some carpet and stuff like that, that we can go ahead and tag on to that part. Or it can be returned to us at 100% if we don't do the project at that point too. So that's the what we've done, I'm just basically agreeing tonight that we will be doing business with all the services. Any questions, guys? Yes.
So we're our bond is roughly 5.5 million. We're approving 4 million. I think you approved 4 million here. What is the plans for the rest of the bond money?
We do have term flexibility. They're not clear on the defense. So we're going to pay.
Okay.
So after that.
Plus the bonds, the selling bonds.
5.3 million. After that, you know, we will look at our other needs.
Because, you know, they've got this bid, but there's still some bids yet to come in. We don't know exactly. But as we go forward, like I said, if we don't run into any major snags, they get in the water line, they find out there's something else that's not in the scope of things, then that's where some of that will be to cover that. Or at the end, like we said, we get down to the end, it looks all clean and everything's going well with no surprises, then that allows us to do some other things. So, you know, we, like I said, we've had some carpet that got put down before that's running ragged, you know, all the way across it, current carpeting that we got. I mean, it wouldn't be hard long for that to get ate up, so. Any other questions? All right, if not, all in favor for performance service bid, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Appreciate you two coming up, though.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Look forward to it, and that's the shortest presentation I've ever had to do, so.
Like I say, this is quite a few ever been. And we appreciate it, like I said. If you guys need to go, because I know you got a ways, feel free to leave.
Thank you all. I look forward to working with you.
As we said, the technology service, has been pulled because we haven't gotten the official bid yet. Is that right?
We were only able to get one of the three.
Oh, okay.
And I did not feel, we did not feel comfortable moving forward with that.
Thank you.
Yes.
All right.
Okay.
That sounds good.
So that's that. All right. Other business. We have the upper room information now. I am actually going to turn this over to Mr. Smith to elaborate a little bit on it, and then you can call up the people for the presentation. And there's the two people to come up with it.
Okay. Just as a little bit of background, I think the board is fully aware of the upper room youth center that has been started. Pastor Brent Oliver is here from the First Assembly of God Church, who represents the Freedom Center, and Tammy McLean, who's the director of the Upper Room, is here to kind of give us some updates. But we've already started a nice partnership. This is a community partnership that is available to all of our students, middle school and high school. And so without me talking a lot, I think I'll ask Brent and Tammy to come up and just kind of give us some updates about what's in. You know, when you say Brent and Tammy that way, it feels natural, doesn't it? I'm glad I didn't call her Oliver by accident.
Yeah, I could really get myself in trouble. Yeah, so you just need to be careful. Yes, I'm a pastor, but about 20 years ago, we initiated the purchase of the former American Legion building. Formed a separate 501 charitable corporation, 501c3 charitable corporation called Freedom Mission Incorporated. It is that corporation with a separate board that actually is the owner and operator of the Freedom Center. Freedom Center has several entities in it and operate under that charitable corporation, this one being the Upper Room Youth Center, which is our latest initiative. Personally, just so that you kind of get a little feel for not only what we do, but also who we are. My wife and I have been part of the community here for 31 years. We've been parents for 31 years. We've been foster parents. 15 years ago, we adopted a sibling group of 4 children. So now we have 6 children and 10 grandchildren. We're very aware of the struggles that kids have today, and not only on the educational side, but the mental and emotional issues that students are going through and even more so because of COVID and everything else going on. The need is great. We've seen it happen. Kids today, honestly, they need us big time. Earlier this year, Mr. Ronk sent, we initiated a conversation with Ms. Circle, who pulled together a group of people. And immediately after that, I think it was Mr. Ronk that sent her a link to a grant opportunity for an after school program she forwarded to us. We got some community people together, and we were actually able to get a Indiana Department of Education COVID-related accelerated learning grant specifically for an after-school program like we have initiated. It's a two-year grant. We got that grant, which enables us to pay stipends to active teachers, retired teachers, and other qualified people who are able to provide tutoring and mentoring for students. So it's just a huge piece that advances us in a big way. Other parts of that grant, I heard the word professional development. There is professional development that can be paid for teachers. Part of this grant that we've received, professional development can be gotten by teachers, and we pay for it through the grant. Also, we have field trips that we can take with kids. The first one coming up is 10 days from now, where the kids that are part of the Upper Room program will be able to go on a field trip. We've been received extremely well by school administrators, conversations that we've had. I would personally like to thank Ms. Circle for seeing the value of our program. The years that I've known her, she's been very much an advocate for students. And if there are things out there that can provide something quality, she's been very much for that. And we appreciate that very much. Angela Bigler was a part of our launch team, a high school counselor here, and has been a huge piece. And we are much farther along today because of her. Her work, her input, and her help. We're certainly available for any questions. Joining me today is Tammy McLean. Tammy's a lifelong resident of Carroll County, who for the last 21 years has served in the Carroll County court system, where she has firsthand seen the needs of Carroll County families. For the past 16 years, she along with her husband has served as assistant directors of a Carroll County-based camp and program for foster children because of her interest in the families and students of our community. We actually hired her to be the director of the Upper Room Youth Center. So I want to let her give you a quick look at what is going on as of right now, what things look like even today.
As he stated, one of our passions is to help the Kansas community. Because of COVID and just the many struggles and challenges that these students face, as many as we possibly can gather around these students, the more chances that we have to change the trajectory of these students in a positive way. The program that we have is a multi-component program. It consists of life skills / culinary for one component. It has activities for another component. The third one is the field trip component, and then there's also the tutoring and mentoring component. In the vision building of this program, we definitely, sought out the teaching and the tutoring. But one thing that we also soon identified is that these students also need emotional and social improvement and development. And so then your mind goes to what are those things that can help that. So the activities component provides mentoring and relationship building activities, not just among the students from each other, but also from adults to students. This in particular is contributing to emotional and social and mental health. It's found that when you spend time with a positive role model, your thinking is also changed into that direction as well. The other one is the life skills and culinary component, which provides students with necessary skills, not just for today, day-to-day processes, but also it helps them for future success as individuals and one day when they start growing families. the first life skill that we had, we just had last Thursday, which was we had a nurse who also has previously been a resident of the community. She actually is a professor now, and she came and she taught the students about life, emergencies, and first aid, and actually worked with the students to build their own first aid kits to take home. So, which resulted in many questions of the students. The other, and actually with that being said, monthly or, you know, every other week, depending on the community members who have volunteered to not only come alongside the program to offer those life skills opportunities, but just, you know, with the creative team that we have, we'll come up with the different ideas for life skills. So we're planning on having them pretty regularly. The other component, the tutoring and mentoring component, it definitely provides one-on-one with the students and gives them access to tutors. And also, it's a continual assessment of the students' grades, their behavioral issues, disciplines, attendance. So part of this component is to assist the students in establishing SMART goals as well. You know, we want them to decrease their attendance issues and decrease their behavioral issues, but we also want to increase their grades. But we want to make sure that they are playing a vital role in that by setting their own goals, and definitely realistic goals. And so our goal for ourselves is to help them reach that. Sometimes walking together with someone to achieve success is easier than walking alone. And as he had stated previously, that we are working hand in hand with Mrs. Bigler. She's been such a huge asset to this program. You know, we're in constant communication of the needs of the students. For example, we had just in the first week, we identified one student who was struggling, not just with behavioral things, but also missing assignments and failing. And so within 1 week, his grades increased to B's and C's. So, and that was working with a tutor for just 1 week. So that's just a small success that we've had. It also helps us help you by working with Mrs. Ziegler, so that way it equips us to know, okay, which direction do we need to go? Do we, you know, add something, take away something? So it's just been a great asset working with her. The other component is field trips. One of the things, especially with the IDOE grant, we are able to offer incentives to students to help them achieve their SMART goals and to, you know, increase their grades and decrease the behaviors and attendance issues. So with that, you know, they can participate in scheduled monthly field trips. We will have guidelines on, you know, in the process of fine-tuning, as you guys know that we are a new program, so sometimes we have to learn as we go, but there will be guidelines for the students to meet. And you know, definitely part of that is achieving their SMART goals. These field trips will also not just provide the social and emotional building aspect, but it will also be having the goal online to provide them an educational experience as well. So currently we have one field trip, as he previously stated, next Thursday. We're going to go to Hillside Acres to have the students pick the apples and kind of experience that. Honestly, you'd be surprised at how many students haven't even done something small like that. Then the idea is to come back with those apples and go into the life skills component to teach them how to bake and do something with the apples. So as you can see, these components are geared to work hand in hand with each other. We have a great group of team leaders who